in some cases, say no to this marine. You don't want to do it. We'll go do it alone. And they are being very, very active. We just had a couple of Taliban, or they believe the Taliban had one, but get out of town, how to measure. And it was the ANA that was performing in the neighborhood here in Washington, trying to catch these guys. They are not the most efficient and together military force sometimes. They look a little ragtag, but when you put them in the line of fire, they know how to fight.
There must have been concern about the fact that there have been civilian casualties, presumably in the long term, that can only be counterproductive, driving people into the arms of the Taliban.
Huge concern. It's clear in the fact that General McChrystal immediately apologized to President Karzai. President Karzai immediately asked for an investigation. The Marine Corps is taking this seriously. They have started their own investigation to figure out how it is that this global positioning system, missile defense system, target was off by about 600 meters, according to ISAF. It's a long way off for them to have missed. Causing sort of casualties, going against the cornerstone of what they're trying to do here. And I think that, you know, the Marines, the ones that I talked to, the higher cadets, they really get it. If you don't have the people on your side, if you can't pit them against the Taliban, you'll never win.
And finally, how's the news about the capture of the senior Taliban commander in Pakistan filtered through to the front line?
It really doesn't play on what is happening here. They may at some point in the future find communications or other indications that he had something to do with all that's happening here. But even at the very top level of ISAF, they aren't commenting on it at the moment. Al-Qaeda and the top leaders of the Taliban are still pretty shadowy. It's not clear how much they have to do with ground operations, like here in Argentina.
Miguel Marquez from ABC. Well, let's hear a little bit more now about life for civilians on the front line. Dawood Azami from the BBC's Pashtun and Persian service has been talking to people in Marja as the international forces moved in. He says they're scared about the future.
They think that Taliban fighters might come back, as they have seen in the past several times. The coalition forces and their Afghan partners would go to an area and they would fight against the Taliban and they would capture that area, and after a few days or a few weeks they would leave that area and the Taliban will come back and they would fill the vacuum. So they don't know what to do. They cannot trust the coalition forces now, although they have said that they are staying this time, they are not leaving soon. But anyhow, they are a bit scared that if they help the coalition forces, if they cooperate with the Afghan forces, there might be a Taliban revenge afterwards.
Dawood Azami. Well, Captain Abe Seitz is the spokesperson for Task Force Lebanon. That's the U.S. force involved in the operation around Marja.
Initially, we met with stiff resistance, I would say, up until yesterday. Resistance today has remained in specific areas. We've seen resistance today has been of a more disorganized nature. Up until this point, we have seen the enemy take up defensive positions, coordinate attacks. The first 3 days of the operation today, we've seen less organization, more hit and run tactics, more small arms fire engagements, and then fleeing of the enemy. That's not to say that coordinated attacks are history, but at least today we've seen less of them.
But overall, this was stiffer resistance than you've been expecting.
It kind of depends on what area of Marja we go into. For the most part, the areas that we've gone into, we've met with relatively light resistance. There are certain pockets in Marja that we've seen heavier resistance. The operation is really focused on going into Marja without disrupting the local national, or at least trying to, and returning the legitimate government of Afghanistan to the region.
There's been more of a disruption, hasn't there?
There's
been actually
been
civilian casualties, 12 of them on Sunday.
I cannot see specifically to civilian casualties at the time. That's an ongoing investigation into them. And unfortunately, the nature of this kind of operation, most operations, and the risk is always there for themselves and people. I would love to prevent those kinds of casualties if and when they do occur, or if we we have information that suggests they've occurred. We take them very seriously and we look into it. And we do want us to prevent those kind of things from happening.
By the Taliban,
you think? We have not gotten anywhere in our area of operations located on the state. We certainly want to be a place where we look at not just Marines, but Afghan national security forces. To include civil war police and government officials, and we will not be leaving town of Marsha until able to defend itself, secure itself, and carry on
the
fight
that
the citizens need to go on.
Captain Abe Sykes.
Chris Murray was in. We didn't waste time. You visited Tom Steele.